Hi viewers, welcome to our channel. This is Kishore Bharavasa. Please subscribe our channel. Till now, anyone not subscribed? Okay. In the previous session, already we are going to discussing about so mathematical calculation of nodal analysis and also where different types of problems of Kirchhoff's laws and source of transmission also we are so already discussing in the previous session. Now today we are going to discussing about problems on nodal analysis. So coming to the nodal analysis here. So the problem will be given like this. The problem will be given like this. Here some independent source is given, one that is like 5 amperes, and also here 10 volts voltage source, also independent voltage source also given here, and also there are different types of various resistance also here given from the given circuit diagram. So first of all, when the circuit diagram will be given like this, first of all we have to indicate to the node points. We have to indicate to the node points, that is the first thing. So let us already know that in the previous session how to get to indicate the node points from the given circuit diagram. We have clearly explained all those things. Okay. So from this, first of all we have to indicate to the, so wherever the points will be existing to the particular node points, so we have to indicate it. So whenever the two elements which is connected to each other, so then only at that particular points we have to indicate to the node points also here. So already know that according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, I is equal to V by R. V is equal to IR, I is equal to V by R. So from that we have to calculate to the all those different types of current equations from the different types of various node points here. Okay, so applying case here, so here Kirchhoff current law based on all we are calculating the total entire currents also here. So here according to, so Kirchhoff current law, so basically find what we are getting here. So from this total circuit diagram we are getting, so I is equal to V by R means, so the total supply voltage how much here, so the total supply voltage here V1, so that is, so what is the total resistance here, so that is given as, so 10 ohms V1 by 10. So and also how much amount of supply we are feeding to the total circuit here, so how much amount of current will be total we are feeding to the entire circuit, so that is given as 5 amperes. So that's why 5 is equal to calculate to the here total entire current from the given circuit diagram. Okay, here basically we are represented to the two nodes, so that's why we are getting to the two expressions. So two expressions are also called as like a two equations we are getting from the circuit diagram. If we want to calculate to the those two equations, so finally we can get into the current equations. Finally we can get into the current equations. Okay, so now let's, if you want to go for here, so this is like 5, so 5 is equal to V1 by 10, and also plus, okay, here some resistance also there. So how can we calculate the voltage of across the resistance here? Simply we can calculate here, so that is given as V1 minus V2 by 3 ohms. V1 minus V2 by 3, already know that. How can we simply indicate to the all those things in the previous class, already we are learning. So and also, so this is the end, and this is the, so this is the final equation from the given circuit node point 1. This is the final equation from the at node point 1 we are getting to the equation like this. Okay, and also, so if you want to simplify this equation, so finally we can get to the one expression is there. So that is why if you want to expand this equation, then we can get like this. So V1 by 10, so if you want to expand this here, what we are getting here, V1 by 3 minus V2 by 3. Okay, so this is the, we are getting, if you want to take the common here V1, so then we can get to the 1 by 10 plus 1 by 3, and also if you want to take the minus V2 coming to here, so then we can get to the 1 by 3. So this is the expression we are getting from the equation 1. Okay, this is the expression we are getting from equation 1. So if you want to calculate to the current expression at node 2, so then what we are getting here, if you want to at node 2, at node 2 we are getting here. So similarly also we are getting, so according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, so that is given as I is equal to V by R. So then we can get to the V2 by 5, and also plus here, so and also some source is there here. Here something will be the different to this problem from the previous problems. Here this is the V2, and also this is the, some voltage source is will be given, some voltage source also here given. So that's why here simply we have to get as V2 minus 10 by
this is the voltage. Voltage means this is like some potential difference also there, and also this is the some voltage node point voltage. This is the some node point voltage here, and also this is the some voltage source. So that's why if you want to calculate the resistance voltage across to the both voltage source, so then we can get to the like this V2 minus 10 by 1, V2 minus 10 by 1. Okay, like this we have to represent it, and also plus. Okay. And here also, so this element, this V2 node element also, which is connected to the 3 ohms resistance also. Why? Because all our images may contain like a junction point here. Why? Because this point also, this connection element also connect to the 3 ohm resistance also. So that's why we are adding to the this node points also from this expression. Okay. So then what we are getting here? So V2 minus V1 by 3. V2 minus V1 by 3. So this is the total expression which will be getting from the node 2 equation, okay. So if you want to simplify this expression, we are getting to the some final expression. So if you want to simplify this equation, okay, so V2 by 5, and if you want to expand this equation, what we are getting here? So V2 by 1 minus 10 by 1, V2 by 1 minus 10 by 1, okay, plus V2 by 3 minus V1 by 3. So this is the final expression we are getting from the equation 2. Final equation we are getting like this. Okay. So if you want to take the common here V2, then what we are getting? So 1 by 5 plus 1 by 1, that is like a 1 here, and also plus 1 by 3, like that we are getting the final expression. Okay. And also if you want to take the, so remaining one of the term is there, like V1 by 3 is there, so that can be putting like this. If you want to take that V1 common here, then minus V1, finally we get into the like this, minus V1 into 1 by 3. So this is the final expression we are getting from the node 2 equation. So here, so total equation like this, so this is equal to 10 volts, so because here the total supply voltage source here, supply to the entire resistance from this side, which is given as 10 volts, so that's why we are putting like this 10 volts also. Okay. So if you want to simplify those two equations, finally you can get to the both I1 and I2 currents. So if you want to solve both expressions, like this first expression as well as this expression, both node 1 and node 2 expression, if you want, you can get to the V1 and V2 values. Both V1 and V2 values we are finally getting. Okay. So here from this expression we are simply going to calculate what we are getting here. Both V1 is equal to 19.8 also we are getting. Okay. And also V2 is also we are getting to the 10.9 volts. 10.9 volts also we are getting from this if you want to solve the both two expressions. Okay. So this is 19.85 volts, and also V2 is equal to 10.9 volts. So if you have any doubt, please put on the comment. I will give you solve the all those things. Okay. And this both two voltage equations we are getting to the individual currents at the each branch. Okay, now if you want to find the total individual branch currents from the various node points, so then we get, if you want to come in for the at node 1 V1, so then we can get here. So here if you want to calculate I10, then we can get to the V1 by 10 here. So according to Ohm's law, we are getting I is equal to V by R. So that's why we are getting V1 by 10. So here already we have calculated the both V1 and V2 voltages from the both node 1 and node 2 particular points. So then we can get here. So here V1 is given, we are getting already 19.85 by R. So 10 at the I10 particular point junction. So finally we can get to the 1.985. Okay. If you have any doubt, please put on the comment box. So and also if you want to go for the I3 here, okay. So let us, so from this junction here flowing to the some I3 terms like this up to this junction, and also so downward junction I10 also flowing. So if you want to calculate to the I3 here, I3 is equal to V1 minus V2 by 3. I3 is equal to V1 minus V2 by 3. Why? Because here, so across the resistance we have to calculate to the total voltage drop here. So then we get V1 minus V2 by 3. So here V1 also already we know that, and also V2 also already we know that. So according to from this, so V1 minus V2 by 3, then we can get finally 2.98 amperes. Okay. And also if you want to go for the like a at node 2 V2, so if you want to calculate here I5, so then we can get I5 is equal to V2 by 5. Here already know that here V2 is equal to 10.9 by 5. So then we can get, so 2.18 angles here. 2.18 angles here. Okay. Here we are calculating to the individual branch cuts to the all particular node points. All particular node points. Okay. And also if you want to go for the I1 current. Here also we are getting V2 minus 10 by 1. V2 minus 10 by 1. So then we can get to here. So here V2 also we are getting 10.9 minus 10 by 1. So finally we can get to the 0.9 amperes. 0.9 amperes. Okay, this is the calculation of individual branch currents with the help of nodal analysis, and also we have to calculate to the individual voltage at each node points. Okay. So this is the today our class. So if you have any doubt, please put on the comment box. I will give you reply. Okay. So thank you, one and all.